Now let us talk about two sources of different frequencies and how do we calculate power. So let us start about power in sources of different frequency. I'll draw a circuit which we have also seen in the previous lecture. Right, this was the question I think we did earlier, where maybe we were asked to find either some of the current or voltages using superposition, right? Right, we did this problem before. So we would use superposition. There are two frequencies here. If you see, one is omega 1 as 5t, one is omega 2 as 10t. So there are two different frequencies, and for different frequencies we cannot directly use phasor, so we first convert it. Use superposition, make one source zero at a time, convert to phasor, find the solution, and then you add either current or voltage because of each circuit. Now the question here is, find P and power factor, let's say of one of the sources, let's say of the voltage source of this source, right? So if you see power, even in DC circuits or even in AC circuits, power is, let's say if I'm talking about a resistance, it is I square R or V square by R, right? So power is not a linear function of current and voltage, right? It is square of current or square of voltage through an element. So we cannot use superposition for power, right? We cannot solve this problem by making one source zero, finding the power flow in that branch or through that source, then make the other source zero, then again find the power through the original source or original branch, and then just add those two powers and reactive powers. We cannot do that, right? Why? Because power is not a linear function. But you can find current and voltages using superposition, right? So here what we do is, first we find, let's say this is the source, so I want to find what is I1 of t, right? So let's say I find I1 of t using superposition. Now this I1 of t would have two frequency terms. Why? Because the circuit has two frequency terms. So let it say it has something like I1 cos of omega 1 t plus theta 1 plus I2 cos of omega 2 t plus theta 2. Right? Where omega 2 and omega 1 are defined. Is that okay? So you would have this kind of answer for your current that is coming from source 1. So this you can find using superposition. Now the next step is to find real power P, which is nothing but equal to what is instantaneous power, average of V of t into I of t, right? What is small v of t? Small v of t is some V1 sine of, or let's say cos, okay, maybe we can put sine here, cos of omega 1 t minus pi by 2, right? I'm just converting sine to cos. And this is V1 of t, it only has one particular frequency, the voltage, but the current now has two frequencies. So it has I1 of cos omega 1t plus theta 1 plus I2 cos of omega 2t plus theta 2. Is that okay? So we want to find the average of this expression, which would actually give me the real power. So if you multiply the first term with the first term of the current, right, then you have two cosines of the same frequencies, right? You have two cosines of the same frequency, and there is a phase angle between these two, right? So now either you can multiply and then find the average, or you can directly write what is going to be real power in this case, which is going to be equal to Vrms, Irms, cos of angle between current and voltage, which is theta 1 plus pi by 2. Is that okay? So either you could have just multiplied, try to find average, right? Then you will have cos A cos B, you can expand into half times cos of A plus B plus cos of A minus B, right? Then one of the term would have frequency, average would become zero. Other term would not have any frequency, which is nothing but what you would get this term. Is this okay with all of you? Now what about the second, first term getting multiplied to the second term? What about if you multiply the voltage term with the second current term? Then again you would have cos A into cos B, right? Now cos A is of frequency omega 1t, cos B is of frequency omega 2. So cos A into cos B is again 1 by 2 times cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Cos A plus B would have omega 1 plus omega 2 term, cos A minus B would have omega 1 minus omega 2 terms. Both are non-zero. Why? Because omega 1 is not equal to omega 2. So omega 1 plus omega 2 is also non-zero, omega 1 minus omega 2 is also non-zero. So if you integrate, what will you get? Zero. So this is the answer for P. Right? So essentially what is power? Power is the fundamental RMS value of the voltage multiplied by fundamental RMS value of the current into cos of angle between the fundamental voltage and the fundamental current. Yeah, so I'll very quickly talk about that. If you see the voltage that you get, right? What is the frequency of the voltage that you get? 50 hertz, roughly, right? If you happen to observe the voltage that you get in your hostel or in your home or in your class, it would not look like a sinusoid voltage, right? It would look like little bit distorted kind of voltage. Similarly, the current that your loads draw, for example, the current that your laptop draws, it does not look sinusoid. It looks something like this. Right? So these waveforms, waveform A is pure sine, B and C. Waveforms B and C, if you see, and if you do a Fourier series expansion of that, what will you see? You will see 50 hertz. And you would also see maybe 150 hertz or other multiples of these frequencies, right? And you can write this thing as some current 1 into cos of 50 2 pi t plus current at, let's say, third harmonic 150 hertz into cos of 50 into 2 pi into 3 times t of this frequency and so on, right? So essentially a waveform that you are getting in your voltage is not a pure sinusoid. It has fundamental component, it has 50 hertz component, and it has harmonic component, right? So that is where I use this word fundamental. So now if you see in this particular example, you had one voltage source which only has fundamental component, does not have any harmonics, we say. It does not have any other frequencies, but the current it is supplying has two frequencies. It has fundamental component, it has other frequencies also. So the power in this case is given by the RMS value of fundamental voltage and the RMS value of fundamental current and the angle between fundamental current and fundamental voltage. Right? So if your voltage only has fundamental component and your current has fundamental plus other components, other frequency components, then the real power is only contributed by multiplication of the fundamental to the fundamental, which would be given by this expression. So do you understand the difference between this term and the term which is RMS of current? If you see, we define current, I'm just going above, as addition of two frequencies. So what is the RMS value of current? What is the RMS value of total current? The RMS of this full expression, right? And what is the RMS value of fundamental? It is only the fundamental current component, which is I1 into cos omega 1 t plus theta 1, RMS value of that component, which is equal to I1 by root 2. And similarly, you can write RMS of the second component, which is I2 by root 2. Right? And what is the total RMS? How you can find total RMS? Same expression, root of mean of square. Here you have two terms, I1 cos omega 1 t plus theta 1 plus I2 cos omega 2 t plus theta 2 dt. So this, if you solve this expression, you would get RMS of the total current. If you only want RMS of the fundamental current, that is only given by the fundamental component RMS. Let me ask you guys to solve the RMS of current. You know what is the answer? What will you get as RMS of current? Do you know that? Yes or no? Okay, then can you guys solve for it? Can you solve for this? Can you tell me what will be the RMS of the current? Total RMS of the current? Yeah, but do you know maybe you guys try it out. Even if some of you know, I still want everyone to try out. You try to solve this integral and try to show that. So could you understand that a voltage or a current waveform may not be pure sinusoid, right? So if you do a Fourier series expansion of that, then you would get 50 Hertz component. And you would get multiple of 50 Hertz component. You may get multiple of 50 Hertz component in that waveform. So usually the 50 Hertz component, we would call it as fundamental component. By 50 Hertz, we mean our supply 50 Hertz, right? Because fundamental component means that is the main component, basic component, right? And then we would say harmonics. Harmonics means multiple of this 50 Hertz. So we would say second harmonic, third harmonic, fourth harmonic. Fourth harmonic means 4 times 50 Hertz, means 200 Hertz. So now come back to, this is the system. Now come back to this question. There are actually two frequencies, right? One is 5T and one is 100. Sorry, there are two frequencies. One is 5 radians per second and one is 10 radians per second, right? So I'm calling omega 1 as the fundamental and 10 as second harmonic of that fundamental, right? So as far as this circuit is concerned, I'm calling omega 1 because I've written it also as omega 1. I'm calling omega 1 as fundamental. Is that okay? So therefore, I1 I am calling it as fundamental. So the term fundamental is relative, right? If you are talking about our supply, then fundamental is 50 Hertz. If you talk about supply in US, then the fundamental is 60 Hertz, right? So fundamental means the main component, main component. So here we are saying that the main component is 5 radians per second. How about the RMS current? So you have square of the full current, so you can write it as A square plus B square plus 2AB, right? Maybe I can solve it. So if you have multiple frequencies in your current, then the total RMS is given by root of square of RMS value of each component. Sorry. RMS value of each component. So the first RMS value was I1 by root 2, second RMS value was I2 by root 2, third is I3 by root 3. So you square of each RMS, you n take root, you get the total RMS. Right? So since you are trying it for two terms, you should get this first thing as the answer. This I can also rewrite as I1 RMS square plus I2 RMS square plus I3 RMS square and so on. In our problem that we are solving, we only have these two components. We don't have three and subsequent components. So again, there should be cos square term plus cos square term of different frequency and plus a cos A into cos B term. That cos A into cos B term, if you take integral, it will come out to be zero. So you would have cos square terms. And if you individually solve, you should get this answer. Okay, let's move on and come back to our problem. So now we understand that if we have a source of voltage which only has one component and the current through it, which let's say has two or maybe more than two or three, four, five, six components, in that case, the real power is given by V1 RMS, I1 RMS, cos of angle between V1 and I1. Is that okay? Now, what happens if your source also has more than one frequency terms? It is possible, right? I told you your voltage also that you are getting in plug may not be pure sinusoid. It may also have other frequency terms in it if you do a Fourier expansion. So let's say I have a source whose voltage is given by V1 cos omega 1t plus phi 1 plus V2 cos omega t plus phi 2. And the current that is flowing is given by I1 cos omega 1t plus theta 1 plus I2 cos of omega 2t plus theta 2. In that case, what will be my capital P? V1 RMS, I1 RMS, cos of theta 1 minus phi 1 plus V2 RMS, I2 RMS, cos of theta 2 minus phi 2. Right. You can, if you're not able to directly get this, you can write the expression for small p of t, right? Find instantaneous power p of t, right? By cross multiplying these terms, so you'll have total four terms, and then you find the capital P by finding average of p of t, right? Two of the terms would be cancel out, they will give you zero. Only two of the terms would give you non-zero values, which are these. Is that okay? So now question is, how do we define power factor here? Do you think power factor is theta 1 minus phi 1 or theta 2 minus, cos of theta 1 minus phi 1 or cos of theta 2 minus phi 2? And this is a very practical situation, right? Because I'm repeating it again that we are talking about our own supply and our own loads, right? We are not creating any hypothetical question here. So would power factor be cos of theta 1 minus phi 1 or theta 2 minus phi 2? It would be neither. Why? Because if you remember, we define that power factor is not cos of something. Power factor is equal to P by S. Right? So let us try to find it that way. So what is S? What is magnitude of S? I have already told you it is VRMS into IRMS. What is VRMS? RMS of the voltage and IRMS, RMS of the current. In this particular case, what is VRMS? In this particular case, VRMS is V1 RMS square plus V2 RMS square. And what is IRMS? I1 RMS square plus I2 RMS square. And therefore, power factor is given by V1 RMS, I1 RMS cos of theta 1 minus phi 1 plus V2 RMS, I2 RMS cos of phi 2 upon root of V1 RMS square plus this is your power factor. Now this looks like a complex formula, right? Maybe let us try to simplify it by taking certain assumptions. So let us assume that only current has multiple frequency component, voltage does not have any multiple frequency component, which was the case with which we started. So let us assume that V2 RMS is 0. Right? So in voltage there is only one component, in current there are two components. So how does this expression simplifies to? So now power factor is equal to V1 R I1 R cos of theta 1 minus phi 1 upon V1 R root of I1 R square plus I2 R square, which can be further simplified to V1R would cancel, I1R I can take in denominator, I can write this expression as 1 upon root of 1 plus I2R square upon I1R square cos of theta 1 minus phi 1. Let me define a term called THD, where THD stands for total harmonic distortion. What does this mean? So I'm defining this term as root of I2R square plus I3R square and so on upon I1R. Right, I'm defining this term. I'm calling it total harmonic distortion. So as the name suggests, as I told you, second harmonic, third harmonic, fourth harmonic, all the multiples of the fundamental, we call it them as harmonics, right? And they are creating distortion. And in this term actually captures all of the harmonics, right? So if, for example, if your I2 RMS, I3 RMS, all of the terms are zero, that means your current is pure sinusoid. That means your total harmonic distortion in the current would be zero, right? So lower the value of THD, better it is. Ideally, THD, we want it to be zero. In real life, it may not be zero. It may be ranging from 1 or 2% to as high as 30%, 40%, 50% also, depending on which kind of load that you are connecting. So now if I substitute the definition of this ITHD into the expression for power factor, then I can rewrite my power factor as 1 upon root of 1 plus ITHD square into cos of theta 1 minus phi 1. Is that okay? So power factor is given by 1 upon root of 1 plus the ITHD square into cos of theta 1 minus phi 1. Okay, now this is what, if you see this term, what is this term? This is very similar to the power factor derivation we did, which is cos of angle between current and voltage, fundamental values, right? Therefore, we call this term as displacement power factor. And this term we call as distortion power factor. right? Why? Because it is coming because of distortion, because of harmonics. There are no harmonics. If there is only one component of current, one component of voltage, then this term would actually be equal to 1, the full term, right? In that case, your power factor would get simplified to the same expression which you have got earlier. Right? Anyone has any doubt in this? So now if you have a, so this expression, you remember we have simplified from a more complex looking expression by assuming that voltage is pure sinusoid. There is no distortion in voltage. That's how we have simplified it. The above expression, this expression is a much more generic expression which you can use if both current is also distorted, voltage is also distorted. Right? And then from that we derive this other expression which is applicable only if your voltage is pure sinusoid. So this is only if voltage has no harmonics, right? Only current has harmonics, voltage is pure sinusoid. Okay. Now we till now we have talked about a single phase supply, right? What you as I told you, what you get in your home, what we are getting in this room is a single phase supply. That means we are getting a single source of 50 hertz of 230 volt RMS, right? But the production of the supply is mostly three phase supply, right? So when you have big power plants, big generators, they would produce three phases of power, right? So they would produce 230, they would not produce 230, but let's say they produce at voltage V and at angle 0, the other would be voltage V at an angle minus 120 and voltage V at an angle minus 240 degrees. That means if you draw phasors, then it will be V phasor. Let me call it this as VA, VB and VC. So you have VA phasor, then VB phasor is lagging VA phasor by 120 degrees. And then you have C phasor, which is lagging B phasor by 120 degrees, right? So whenever you produce electricity, you usually produce it in terms of these three voltage phasors. They would come out of your generator. And then you distribute it. One phase may go to some of the rooms or some of the hostels. The other phase may go to some other room, some other houses or some other thing. So you sort of distribute it and you connect your individual loads which are connected on single phase. But the power that we are getting is three phase. So now what we would do is we would, in the next lecture, we would study about this three phase source. And we would try to again solve circuit related problems using these three phase sources and also try to find power, reactive power, complex power in case of these three phase sources, right? Okay, I think we'll continue next time then.